I am Ian Somerhalder, president and founder of the Ian Somerhalder Foundation. The reason I started ISF was in a post-Katrina world, seeing kind of insane climate destruction and the resource pool being sort of tapped to no end over and over and over again. And I realized I never want to feel that powerless again. I feel more empowered now just having this. One of the many projects which this will help in great part is we're building a sanctuary, an animal sanctuary that's also going to double as a sustainable agriculture farm and triple as a youth education camp. When a young person comes to that farm, they leave with a different understanding of compassion. If you have compassion for an animal, then ultimately you will learn to have compassion for other people.
I got involved with this event by, I have a foundation, the Ian Somerhalder Foundation, and using social media, the Ian Somerhalder Foundation has become such a force in the world in the development and the protection of animals, both domestic, stray, and not non-domestic animals. So I am fortunate and honored enough to be here, to be with all you guys.
That I got to hang out with my kid, with my moak. That was the kicker right there. Being able to hang with my animals, kind of amazing, and letting the rest of the world see this incredible creature that I happen to live with, that I wake up every morning with him on my
on my face.
But you know what, man? You're a big animal lover, right?
I am.
I found it out. That's awesome. Thank I like that.
I think we all are.
Dog.
I just rescued an animal, yes, and it was the craziest thing. I've had a premonition about this animal since I was 16.
What kind of animal?
It's a little yellow lab pit bull mix. Pits get the worst. You know, they're so misunderstood, it's ridiculous.
And you had a crazy incident with the dog, right?
Yeah, her name's Nietzsche.
Nietzsche!
And yeah, we took her to get spayed, because that's what you do. And my assistant called and said, are you sitting down? I said, no. Don't tell me the dog died, the anesthesia is something. I went to the parent place. But no, the dog's very alive. But she's pregnant.
Did they do a sonogram or something?
Like six babies coming. No, they opened her up to spare her, and there were all these little puppies in there. Like, no, sew it back up, closer. Oh. So they're just sutured up, and so they told her husband, they said, hey, listen, so if you see like a paw or anything come out, just push it back and bring her here. And he turned pale. Freak. A paw, like a shoulder, a head.
Oh,
so
wow.
Now I am I'm a proud dad of about to be seven dogs.
Uh-huh.
Thank you.
You love animals. You talked about animals.
Love them, man. I do tend to dislike a great deal animals used in entertainment. I just do. The circus makes me like want to jump off a building.
Yeah.
You know, totally. These animals, there's no reason, and I know it's cool for kids to see, but there's just no reason you need, you know, 6,000-pound elephants in captivity living lives of total isolation and abuse. I mean, just it's 2013, man. It's really not, and I'm definitely not trying to offend anyone. Obviously, if I say something to offend someone, I'm not. That's not my intention.
I know.
But it's those types of things. You know, a little statistic: there are more tigers in captivity in Texas than there are in the wild.
You asked the question: where does social media? What role does it play? It plays the biggest role. Being able to access that amount of people and inspire them, empower them, and then activate them, that's the new paradigm. That's the future. That's what's happening.
And then I look at your page here, and you're I mean, look at this. You're making some moves here yourself here, man. You're making
all those donations coming in right now.
Donations are coming in as
just right now.
Yeah.
Yes.
So cool.
And keep the donations coming.
Yes, please. It's pretty incredible. I mean, creating a platform, particularly because the youth component, Vampire Diaries, the demographic is primarily of a younger set.
Yeah.
And being able to empower young people with news, it's not just news, it links news to an action.
And this generation is a very challenged generation. This is I honestly think it's a very amazing time to grow up. It's also a very tough time to grow up right now.
Oh yeah.
And so I think that the most thing that we can do is instill a great work ethic in young people. And that's what we're doing, ISF. And so if we can educate and activate and empower the kids coming up now, I say kids, the young people now. Today we were doing this photo shoot for Cree. It's an LED company that's just come up with the LED incandescent light bulb that is probably the most energy-saving light bulb on the planet. I don't even think probably. I would say it is the most energy-saving light bulb on the planet that creates really exceptionally beautiful light. A light bulb that looks like the regular incandescent light bulbs that we're used to seeing and using and buying, except that it's LED and it uses 84% less energy. It produces such low heat, you can't even feel it. The Vampire Diaries is given us in the world is this ability to speak about things that we love, whether it's LED light bulbs or it's conservation, whether it's habitat or species. It's allowed us to have a really phenomenal presence in Washington, D.C. and working with the upper echelons of the executive branch of the government, all these really phenomenally huge organizations.
Honestly, the Ann Somerhalder Foundation would not exist without this. Things like the Teen Choice Awards, this is what makes this foundation thrive. It's the nuts and the bolts of the foundation. It's the backbone of the foundation. It's the only thing that makes it work. So the left and the right side, both parties have to come together and understand that conservation is a national security threat issue to the United States of America. It's a national security issue to every single nation in the world. So we don't need to pay it forward. What we need to do is we need to stop it now, conserve now, so that we don't end up in a crisis situation in the future. Do things, simple things. Turn the lights off when you leave.
Recycle.
Please.
It is now my great, great, great honor to present the EMA Futures Award to Ian Somerhalder.
Wow. Guys, thank you to the Environmental Media Association for this unique honor. This is really quite incredible. Listen, as a result of being in this entertainment industry, I realize that I, like many of us in this room, have a unique ability to reach the vast portion of the public. Now, this visibility creates a substantial opportunity to shine a light on the things that are really important to us that we need to fix in the world and what we need to do is create very serious change. So when we created ISF, we wanted to find a really great way to tap into the younger demographic. The world's youth is truly our most undervalued, underappreciated, and underused resource that we have, truly. They're the real future. Why not empower them? So it's our responsibility to share with them what my generation is learning so they can carry the torch and make things better for the generation to follow using compassion and innovation. It's really the most basic concept, really. But often we make the mistake that by assuming that we need to wait for children to grow up before we start to have these conversations about how to improve our world. And sort of in doing that, I think we miss out on their unadulterated creativity that has none of the barriers or limitations that we place on ourselves as grown-ups. And these ideas are born from free thinking that we truly change how we solve our environmental issues, and it's time that we begin leveraging what opportunity inexperience provides. So I'll leave you with this. With the IS Foundation, we wanted to give youth an amplifier so that their voices and ideas were heard. It's truly, it's as simple as that. And hopefully, by empowering, educating, and collaborating with other with people projects, the IS Foundation has become a resource for kids and young adults to learn to become inspired. So I can tell you that I've been inspired by so many of these kids, and the one thing that you see with all of them is that they are so inspired, but they don't have a voice. If we give them this voice, it's quite an incredible thing. You watch them grow and you watch them change. So that through the lens of compassion, we see life differently. If we can show, not teach, we can show our youth compassion for whether it's an animal, a tree, one another, their lives will be infinitely better, and I think therefore ours. So we have a lot to look forward to. The future is bright. Wear your sunglasses. Thank you.
For more information about the IS Foundation and what we're doing, please go to isfoundation.org and check it out.